Today we will take some more problems on circles. Now first problem, a circle is touching the side BC of a triangle ABC at P and touching AB and AC produced at Q and R respectively. Then prove that AQ is equal to half perimeter of triangle ABC. Perimeter of triangle ABC. Now this we have to prove. Now solution. Now it is given that a circle is touching the side BC of a triangle ABC at P, and AB produces at Q, and AC produces at R. We have to prove that AQ is equal to half of perimeter of triangle ABC. So we will take perimeter of triangle ABC. Perimeter of triangle ABC. Now this is equal to AB plus BC plus CA. Now AB plus BC plus CA. अब हम क्या करेंगे कि BC को हम दो पार्ट में डिवाइड कर सकते हैं. So BC can be written as BP plus PC and plus CA. तो हमने BC को क्या लिख लिया? BP plus PC. So this is equal to AB plus BP. Now we can write BP is equal to BQ and PC is equal to CR, because here BP is equal to BQ and PC is equal to CR, because length of tangents drawn from external point are equal. Length of tangents drawn from external point are equal. इसलिए हमने BP की जगह BQ रख दिया एंड PC की जगह CR रख दिया. Now AB plus BQ. Now this AB plus BQ will be equal to AQ plus CA plus CR. So this will be equal to AR. Now AQ plus AR. Now again AR is equal to AQ, because again length of tangent drawn from external point are equal. So this is length of tangents. So we can say perimeter of triangle ABC, this is equal to twice AQ. Therefore AQ is equal to half perimeter of triangle ABC. AQ is equal to half perimeter of triangle ABC. Now this we have to prove. So hence prove. Okay, next problem. The radius of the incircle, the radius of the incircle of a triangle is 4 cm, is 4 cm, and the segments into which one side is divided by the point of contact are 6 cm and 8 cm. Determine the other two sides of the triangle. Determine the अदर टू साइड्स ऑफ द ट्राइंगल, अदर टू साइड्स ऑफ द ट्राइंगल. So it is given that the radius of the inner circle of a triangle is 4 cm and the segment into which side is divided by the point of contact are 6 cm and 8 cm. Now we have to find the other two sides of the triangle. Now solution. It is given that in triangle ABC, the inner circle of this triangle touches the side AB, BC and CA. Now the point of contact of one side, let BC, divides the segment into 6 and 8 cm. So here BR equal to BP equal to 6 cm length of tangents, length of tangent are drawn from external point, drawn from external point are equal. Similarly, CQ will be equal to CP equal to 8 cm. Again, the reason is same, length of tangent drawn from external point are equal. And let AR equal to AQ and this be x cm. Again by the same reason, length of tangent drawn from external point are equal. Now we can say that area of triangle ABC, this be equal to area of triangle AOB plus area of triangle BOC plus area of triangle AOC. Area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle AOB plus area of triangle BOC plus the area of triangle AOC. Now what is the area of triangle? Area of triangle AOB is half into base. So base for AOB is 6 plus x. And height is radius of circle in circle 4 plus half BOC, the base is 6 plus 8 means 14 multiplied by 4 plus half base is 8 plus x multiplied by 4. So take out common half multiplied by 4, so it will become 6 plus x plus 14 plus 8 plus x. So this will be equal to 2 multiplied by 28 plus 2x or 4 multiplied by 14 plus x. Now this is the area of triangle. Now again we will find the area of triangle by using Hirom's formula. Area of triangle ABC by Hirom's formula. Now semi-perimeter S equal to 6 plus x plus 14 plus 8 plus x upon 2. Now this is equal to 14 plus x. So this is the semi-perimeter of this triangle. Now area of triangle ABC. Now this is equal to S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. So this is equal to S is 14 plus X. Now A, let A is 14, so 14 plus X minus 14, this is equal to X. Now 14 plus X minus 6 plus X, this is equal to 8, and 14 plus X minus 8 plus X, 6. So this will become 48X multiplied by 14 plus x. So this is the area of triangle by Hirom's formula. Now by equating these two area we will get under root 48x multiplied by 14 plus x. This is equal to 4 multiplied by 14 plus x. Now squaring both sides, 48x multiplied by 14 plus x, this is equal to 16, 14 plus x whole square. Now 14 plus x, 1 14 plus x can be cancelled because x is not equal to minus 14. So we will get 3x is equal to 14 plus x, or 2x equal to 14. So here x will be equal to 7 cm. X is equal to 7 cm. So the other two sides of the triangle are AB, this is equal to 6 plus x, so this will be equal to 6 plus 7 and equal to 13 cm, and AC, now this is equal to 8 plus x, so 8 plus 7 equal to 15 cm. So the other two sides of the triangle are 13 cm and 15 cm. Okay, next problem. In figure, L and M are two parallel tangents. Are two parallel tangents at A and B. The tangent at C max and intercept D between L and M. Now prove that angle DFE equal to 90 degree. Now we have to prove angle DFE equal to 90 degree. Now this figure is given to you. Here L and M are the two parallel tangents at A and B. The tangent at C intercept D between L and M, then we have to prove that angle DFE equal to 90 degree. Now solution. Join AF, FD, FC, FB and FE. Now this is 90 degree. Now in triangle AFD and triangle CFD, angle FAD is equal to angle FCD, each 90 degree. AF equal to FC radius, and FD equal to FD common. Therefore, by RHS congruency, triangle FAD is congruent to triangle FCD. Therefore, by CPCT, angle FDA is equal to angle FDC. Now, similarly, triangle FCE is congruent to triangle FBE. by CBCT angle FEC is equal to angle FEB. Now let this is be equal to angle 1 and this be equal to angle 2. Now because L is parallel to M, therefore angle ADC plus angle BEC is equal to 180 degree. Angle ADC plus angle BEC is equal to 180 degree. Now these two angles are co-interior angles, and the sum of the co-interior angle is 180 degree. Now angle ADC can also be written as twice of angle FDC, and angle BEC can also be written as twice of angle FEC. So angle FDC plus angle FEC, twice of angle FDC. So twice of angle FDC plus angle FEC equal to 180 degree. Now we have suppose angle FDC equal to 1 and angle FEC equal to 2. So twice angle 1, twice of angle 1 plus angle 2 equal to 180 degree. Therefore angle 1 plus angle 2 equal to 90 degree. Now in triangle FDE, in triangle FDE, angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle DFE equal to 180 degree. Sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Now angle 1 plus angle 2 is 90 degree. So angle 90 degree plus angle DFE equal to 180 degree. Therefore angle DFE equal to 180 minus 90. So this is equal to 90 degree. So angle DFE is equal to 90 degree. Next problem, from a point P, two tangents PA and PB are drawn to a circle with center O. A, OP is equal to diameter of circle. OP is equal to diameter of circle. Prove that triangle APB is equilateral. Triangle APB is equilateral. Now solution. Now it is given that PA and PB are the tangent to a circle from external point P, and we have to prove that triangle PAB is an equilateral triangle if OP is equal to the diameter of the circle. It is given that OP is equal to diameter of the circle. It means OP is equal to diameter, so let it be 2R and OA equal to R, and let this angle be theta. So we can say in triangle OPA, if you use sine theta is equal to OA upon OP. Sine theta is equal to OA upon OP. So sine theta, this is equal to OA, OA is R and OP is 2R. So this will be equal to 1 by 2. Now from here theta will be equal to 30 degree. Now angle OPA is equal to angle OPB. So this is equal to 30 degree. Therefore angle APB is equal to twice of 30 and this is equal to 60 degree. Now in triangle APB, angle PAB is equal to angle PBA, let it be equal to AX, because PA equal to PB. Length of tangent drawn from external point R equal. Therefore, in triangle PAB, angle APB plus angle PAB plus angle PBA equal to 180 degree. Angle sum property of triangle. So angle APB is 60 degree. Now this be X. Again this is equal to X. So equal to 180 degree. So twice X is equal to 180 degree minus 60 degree. This is equal to 120 degree. Therefore X is equal to 60 degree. There so angle PAB is equal to angle PBA equal to angle PAPB and all are equal to 60 degrees. So triangle, therefore triangle PAB is an equilateral triangle. Therefore triangle PAB is an equilateral triangle. Okay, thank you.